Daimler Truck North America's Super Truck 2 project is a follow-up to Super Truck 1. The objective of the first project was a 50% improvement in freight efficiency over a baseline 2009 model Cascadia. DTNA's engineers smashed that target, upping efficiency by a whopping 115%. They achieved that using a bunch of really high-tech wizardry and ultra-light components. With Super Truck 2, the target was to double the freight efficiency of the baseline truck. The folks who work up on the 13th floor succeeded this time too, but by focusing on the basics: improved aerodynamics, increased powertrain efficiency, and reductions in parasitic losses and rolling resistance. That's what makes this effort all the more remarkable. The truck DTNA revealed in Las Vegas at the end of January looked more like the familiar Cascadia than the bullet-shaped Super Truck 1. That truck really was a science project. The engineers learned a lot about what's possible. Super Truck 2 stuck closer to what's practical.
This time with Super Truck 2, we built on those learnings.
That's DTNA's Director of Advanced Engineering, Derek Rotz.
We learned in Super Truck 1 which technologies showed promise for production. We also learned which technologies did not show promise for production. And when we set up Super Truck 2, we said we want to focus on those things we think will stand the best chance for production.
Let's walk through some of the features of DTNA's Super Truck 2, beginning with the aerodynamics. The company says it achieved a 12% improvement in aerodynamic efficiency by redesigning the hood, bumper, and chassis fairings. Some of the changes are obvious, like the new bumper and the bumper ducts that direct the air around the front of the truck. Others are more subtle, such as the skirts at the bottom of the doors. Changes to the grille and air intakes, and even the mounting arm for the mirror camera, were redesigned to be as seamless and as clean as possible. There are no sharp edges anywhere to interfere with the airflow over the surface of the truck.
So my team was incredibly excited about this opportunity. We wanted to create something that we felt like when the viewer sees it, they can see the efficiency. We were very much inspired by, I would say, nature, because we're trying to find a way to make efficiency beautiful, to make it cool, to make it exciting, to give it a soul.
This fellow is the truck designer with the soul of a poet. He's DTNA's design development manager, Jeff Kottner.
And so because we live in the Pacific Northwest, there's mountains all around us, we were very much inspired by the way the wind can kind of blow through surfaces like snow and sand and actually create the perfect shape.
The truck also features active side cab extenders and a roof spoiler system that deploy at highway speeds. They close the gap between the tractor and the trailer to just 4 inches. An active ride height control system lowers the suspension height by a couple of inches to close the gap between the road surface and to lower the overall frontal profile of the truck. Switching now to the new and improved powertrain, under that slippery new hood is a prototype DD13 engine. It has two-stage turbocharging with an intercooler between the two turbos to increase airflow at low engine speeds. A lot of work was done inside the engine to reduce friction, such as using lighter viscosity oils and friction-reducing coatings on various surfaces. They also added thermal barrier coatings within the combustion chambers to improve thermal efficiency. The fuel injection system was overhauled as well, eliminating mechanical losses, while the injection pressure was increased to 36,000 PSI. Out in the back, DTNA uses something they call adaptive tandem axles. A clutch mechanism located on the forward differential housing allows the axles to shift from 6x4 to 6x2 at highway speeds. Another fuel-saving feature called load biasing uses suspension pressure to shift weight to the extra-low rolling resistance tires on the tag axle rather than driving with the higher rolling resistance drive axle tires. It also has a downsped driveline with a 1.75:1 ratio for an engine speed of just 950 RPM at highway cruising speed. Also new on Super Truck 2 is a prototype 13-speed transmission. DTNA says these improved powertrain features led to an overall fuel consumption improvement of 5.7% compared to Super Truck 1. SuperTruck 2 also has a combination 12 and 48 volt electrical system. The 12 volt side runs all the usual loads like lights and windshield wipers and onboard electronics, etc. The 48 volt circuit enables electric power steering, an electric oil pump, a single circuit electric air conditioner, and a 48 volt starter motor. These things all take loads off the engine, leaving more power to get to the wheels while allowing more precise control of those systems. Because these critical systems are electrically powered, they can continue operating even when the engine is turned off. And that brings us to yet another fuel-saving feature of SuperTruck 2, EcoSail. With EcoSail, the truck can coast or roll down a slight grade with the engine shut completely off for even greater fuel savings. DTNA says that during testing of the EcoSail system, they found the engine was off almost 30% of the time on certain routes. DTNA collaborated with Michelin on the development of new tires specifically designed for adaptive tandem axles. The XM586 traction tire and the free-rolling XM590 tires on the drive axles reduce tractor rolling resistance by 12% compared to SuperTruck 1. To explain, here's DTNA's Manager of Advanced Vehicle Systems, Derek Villeneuve.
These are unique tires from the steer tire, the drive axle, and the tag. And again, these tires, we got a 12% rolling reduction on the tractor itself from what we did on SuperTruck 1. And for those of you that may be familiar with SuperTruck 1, you'll know that we had Super Singles. And so we have duals on here that were more efficient than what we had on SuperTruck 1 and Super Singles. So some of the unique things here, you know, it looks like a tire, but it's so much more than that. These tires have a brand new structure for the carcass of the tire. There's a lot of new materials involved there, as well as with the tread design and the other materials.
Well, that's about it for Daimler Truck North America's SuperTruck 2 effort this year. They managed a 100% improvement in freight efficiency over a 2009 truck, including nearly 6% fuel savings, all using components and technology that already exist. Watch for some of this to be rolled out on fleet trucks over the next few years. Meanwhile, DTNA has already begun work on SuperTruck 3. It'll be a hydrogen fuel cell electric truck configured for over-the-road applications. We should see that one revealed sometime in 2027. Don't forget to subscribe to Heavy Duty Trucking's YouTube channel and give us a like. That helps other people to find us. Check out our other social media channels too. We're on Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. And remember, there's lots of great written content about the trucking industry on our website, truckinginfo.com. I'm Jim Park. Thanks for watching.